end of the threat against the British home islands and colonial possessions from the French Empire, the British were free to expand their trade routes and gain more colonies. This extended the Industrial Revolution to the rest of the world, as well as a more secure international trade. Britain also had a great distaste for the slave trade and had outlawed the slave trade in the British Empire by 1818. The Royal Navy would eventually be the key factor in shutting down the slave trading ports of West Africa over the next few decades. Through trading needs, several wars were fought, most notably in China, over the trade imbalance. First it was against the British for tea and silk, but this would be reversed through opium. The opium wars, on the surface reprehensible, had its better points as well. The Qing Empire was hated by the vast majority of Chinese. Many rebellions erupted through the 19th century, especially around the time of the Opium Wars. The Han, Hakka, and Muslim populations seized upon this chance to try to free themselves of the Qing dynasty. They were seen as foreigners, and Manchuria was considered to not be a real part of China. Perhaps 100 million people died within China in their efforts to be free. Meanwhile, Britain established its trade routes and centers in Hong Kong, Shanghai, Singapore, and other locations. Weapons were the main thing that Asian powers wanted to buy from the British. The same was also true of the other Western powers. Tea, silk, copper, and weapons, especially for the Boshin War period and Meiji Restoration, were the main points of trade, especially for Japan. One man particularly stood out in this period: Thomas Blake Glover. This young lady, Miranda from Texas, will now tell you about her.
Thomas Blake Glover was born in Fraserburgh, Aberdeenshire, Scotland, on the 6th of June, 1838. He died on the 16th December 1911 in Tokyo at the age of 73. He was a businessman who brought many important new industries and technologies to Japan, as well as got involved in the Meiji Restoration. He was married to Yamamura Tsuru. He was educated in a parish school in Scotland, and following that, got a job as a shipping clerk for a trading company. He was probably a Freemason, but there is no direct proof of that. The gate with the Freemason insignia was actually moved here from the Masonic Lodge in Matsugai Machi, near where the cruise ships come to port today. He was a Boy Scout in his hometown, and they were run by the Freemasons then, so it is a skill likely that he was too. He had a lot of close business contacts who were Freemasons as well. In 1859, when Glover was 21, he crossed from Shanghai to Nagasaki and started buying green tea. 2 years later, he founded his first company, Glover & Company. His home is now known as the oldest Western-style building in Japan. Anti-Western feelings were common in Japan, partially due to the unbalanced treaty of the Kanagawa with American Commodore Perry. Nationalistic militants in Satsuma and Choshu started anti-shogunate efforts to restore the empire to full power. Glover decided to supply these factions with guns and warships. This violated treaty agreements with Britain and Japan, as well as Japanese law. The Bakufu requested to Queen Victoria not to allow the trade. The shogun himself sent a letter. Glover said that he feels sorry for us, but there is nothing he can do, to the Satsuma and Choshu. But then he gave them a way to around it. He said that they could send a ship directly to Shanghai to buy rifles, which he supplied from there. Glover would do everything in his power to buy and load as many guns as he wants. He seems deeply committed to us on this matter. Eventually, he just directly traded the rifles in Nagasaki anyway. He didn't tell his crews about the guns in the ships either. if he was caught, he could be prohibited from trading in Japan for 3 years, fined, or imprisoned. In 1863, Glover helped the Koshu Five travel to Japan. He brought a small-scale locomotive and cars to Japan. He demonstrated them in the Oda area of Nagasaki on a short track. It got the Japanese more interested in the use of trains. Glover helped to take down the Tokugawa Shogunate in the Boshin War from 1868 to 1869. He was very friendly with the Meiji government after that. His new connections led to his being responsible for commissioning one of the first warships in the Imperial Japanese Navy, the Joshomaru, later called the Rojumaru. That and other ships were built by a shipyard in Aberdeen, Scotland. He even had the warship Kagoshima built just for the Satsuma clan. In 1868, he developed a coal mine in Saga on Hashima Island. He also bought the first dry dock to Japan. Glover went bankrupt in 1870, but still kept managing his coal mine until it was taken over by the Japanese government. Glover was an important person in the industrialization of Japan. He helped found the shipbuilding company that was to become Mitsubishi Corporation of Japan. He helped with William Copeland's Spring Valley Brewery in Yokohama. He also helped establish the Japan Brewery Company, which later became Kirin Brewery Company, Ltd. An urban myth is that the mustache on the lion in the Kirin beer logo is his mustache. He was presented with one of Japan's highest awards, the Order of the Rising Sun and the Silver Star. He was also known as the Scottish Samurai in Scotland. He died in Tokyo, but he is buried in Nagasaki. His son Thomas is linked to the story of Madame Butterfly, as was Pierre Loti Madame's Chrysanthemum. The story takes place here in the old Nagasaki harbor area.